Igor, well, Igor, the head of the department, has sent down, here to, what is he even doing? This doesn't look, no, something's definitely wrong here.
Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky here in the Lab-RAT-ory. In today's episode, we are doing a little bit on revisiting glues. You know, gluing glues and gluing, it's sort of an ongoing process here in the laboratory. We're always experimenting with all sorts of new glues. But we also have our workhorses. So let me walk you through quickly some of the basics of some of the glues that we use here in the laboratory. Glues we use. Oh yeah, that sounds like a kid's show, doesn't it? This is our workhorse by far. This is what we use when we are working with naked styrene. When we're trying to glue plastic, this is what we use. We also use a combination of liquid glue and cut-up sprues to make our own little plastic filler, which can be used, and we've used it many times here as a glue in itself. But this is Tamiya Extra Thin Cement, and we use it all the time on everything. But later, when you start doing sub-assemblies, and certainly when the model is painted and you're getting ready to glue, there's a glue that, of course, is missing from this whodunit lineup, and that is testers clear. We used the little tubs of that for installing not only our chrome parts, but also our bezel, light bezel glass. Sometimes we use it for the tiniest of parts, you know, rear lights, that kind of thing, door handles, that kind of thing. But anyway, we also want to talk a little bit about, you know, how we apply our glue here in the laboratory. We are applying, you know, we're working on getting these planks attached to our bed in old borax. So we're often tempted to use, of course, the standard, which is crazy glue, different kinds of crazy glues, as you can see here, which you can readily pick up. You can also pick up crazy glue that dries super fast, or which dries super slow. So you could also use 5-minute epoxy resin in two parts. We love this for all sorts of sub-assemblies, and sometimes working on resin parts, like those Gibson engine parts, things like that. We also use glossy accents. These are glues that you can find at the craft store, and glossy accents dries clear, dries glossy, but that part doesn't really matter. But it's very good glue, and it sets up fairly quickly, though it gives you a little bit of wiggle room. Of course, the old standard Elmer's glue, white glue, which we still use, is fantastic. We also have found a new glue called Glue and Seal, which, like white glue, has a long working time, and it's very good for gluing things like you know, different materials, wood to plastic, plastic to metal, wood to metal, any combination thereof. So we like it for that reason. We still use the old, you know, standard In this case, tester's model glue. We use that. We also use this, which comes, of course, with a very, very, look at that. It fell out. Or actually, it probably came off. It's in there, but it's come off. It's got a little needle. Oh, well. We use this all the time. But it doesn't matter, really, if the needle is there, because this is what we normally do, okay? Whatever glue you are working with, okay? For example, this glue and seal comes with its own little brush. So normally what we do is we end up putting a big, depending on how much you need, you know, a big dollop, inventing new words here in the laboratory all the time, folks. Now, this is our standard applicator in most cases, especially if we're using super glues. These are big-headed, colorful straight pins that we use for applying all the time, whether they're large or small parts, because the smaller the tip, the less damage you are going to do. And glues, you know, depending on the glue, it goes a long ways. So the other one, of course, is the toothpick. And we have a handy dandy applicator here, which is very heavy, by the way, so you can never be afraid of it tilting it over, but it holds your toothpick like that. Woohoo! Big deal. So we use a very sharp tip, small tip, and you pick up a little bit of glue, you know. Basically, that's it. That's all the glue you need. And you come over here and you basically get your part, you know, and put a little bit of it on one end and a little bit on the other, maybe in a couple of little places here and there, you know. It's not a big deal. And again, as you go, you pick up these skills very quickly. Making a little bit of room there, making sure my big hands hold me down. All right. And of course, once you place it, it doesn't really matter if the others, you know, as a matter of fact, it's good if all the others come off so that you can work peace of mind. And that's pretty much it. You know, you don't want glue to be coming out, and it just a little goes a long ways. Right? We decided that this one we are going to roll over so that it begins to look like, even though I hate to do it, because I mean, these planks turned out so well, you know. Again, use just a little bit of glue, use it sparingly, right? And, you know, always try to set the part as closest to where you're going to put it as is humanly possible, making sure that none of it is going to seep out. All right, and there you go. And so you just go building, you know, your gluing, you know, from step to step, and you should be fine. And I use these little pieces of paper as a glue holder. So there shouldn't be any mystery to your glue application. And like I tell you, one of the things that we do is we collect all kinds of glues all the time. We tend not to buy a lot of it, though. It's funny me saying that, because here you have like 15 year supply right there. But the crazy glues go bad eventually. If you leave it on cap, it'll dry out. It'll just make a big mess. But you know, that's a risk we're willing to take here in the laboratory. And that's it. We like white glue for mock-up, okay, because you can apply it and it, you know, it starts to get a little sticky along the way, and that's what you want. And then when you're done, you just soak the model overnight in warm water, and everything comes off again, and you can clean it, you know. So really wonderful tools to have. And you could, you know, goop, for example, absolutely wonderful also for for mocking up and holding parts, you know, as you do your sub assemblies together. So you can tack, you can use this to tack parts together. So, you know, as you go out and look for glues, you know, keep an open mind and keep a variety of glues, and you naturally will begin to find the glues that really work for you and the glues that you love to work with. And so it's an organic process, and it doesn't take long, but it takes a little bit, you know, a year or so, for you to get a good idea of what works for you and what doesn't. All right, my friends, I hope you found this useful, and we'll be back with more Cranky Show before you can ask, what time is it?